Hi, it's Serena from Design Plus School. Welcome to my tutorial. So today we will learn how to create this to this. I will show you how to turn the UI to 3D perspective. Don't worry, it's gonna be easy. So let's get started. First of all, you will need this plugin. It's named Skew That from 4.co. This is gonna help you to skew your design to make like a 3D perspective. So just go to the community plugin, search Skew That. There you go. So install, boom, your plugin's there. I actually always use this plugin for most of my design to make like a 3D effect like this. With Skew That, you can skew anything you want at once and your design will stay perspective. So let's create a new one. What you need to do is group everything together because we're gonna skew that in the same time. So when your UI, your design, whatever is ready, so group together. Command G, group, right click, plugin, and then skew that. Change the position. For my design, I use a minus 44, like this, horizontal skew, when they move from horizontal left to right. And for the vertical skew, I go at 32, it's fine, like that. So when you satisfy with your position, then apply, boom, it's skewed. Next step you're gonna do, we're gonna recreate this shape to make a body, to make like a 3D effect. We're gonna duplicate this shape, but first of all, this UI is made inside of the frame, and the frame, the corner radius is at 30. So we're gonna put at 0 first, so we can draw this rectangle. So P for pen tool, or you can just go in the top for the tool pen. So we're gonna recreate this rectangle. You don't need to make this very perfect because we're gonna edit after. So just draw the rectangle like this. So put any color you want for now. And then take up the stroke. We don't need that. When you're done, click done. Okay, make sure this layer is at the bottom of this card because the edge should be in the bottom of the card. When you put it down, we see this body. You can name this layer body or edge, whatever you want. So select the two layers together and put the corner radius at 30 degrees. Boom, it changed in the same time. Now you need to flatten first. So right click, flatten this layer, because if you don't flatten, the shape will stay rectangle. It's not that I want. So flatten, when you edit this shape, see it's round now. Next, we're gonna connect the body to this car. So enter, we're gonna edit all the corner. So I'm gonna put the corner in the top a little bit like that, like an iPhone, you know. Same thing for this one. So you can do manually, bring everything on the top corner like this and done. It should be like this. The body is created. So we're gonna do the same thing for this card. Let's do the same thing for the rest of the UI element here. So this one. There you go. So when you're done, now let's create the gradient color here on the body. You can put any color you want, but for my design, for this card, I put a different color. Right click the body layer, click color on fill. Instead of solid, I choose linear. Linear is the most common and wisely used gradient out there. In a linear gradient, the color of the gradient blend from star color to end color in a straight line like this. So you can add many color you want. For this example, I try to follow the same background. So the first color should be the same as this one. So take the dropper, use this color, add more gradient, do the same thing, add this second color. I will do the same thing. I try to follow this line. I'm gonna continue for the rest of the card. The final look like this for the linear color. Now let's create something more beautiful, more elegant. So I'm gonna take up all of this card. I'm gonna take off from this frame. Okay, set everything. and put outside from the screen. Like this. Now you can play a little bit with them. Make like it's floating. So this one I'm gonna make more from the top, but make sure the layer is in order. So this one I want in top of this one on number 3. So let's make on this top. So follow the number. Something like this. Now it really look like the card is floating. Let's make this one a little bit like that. Okay, let's hide the rest. Now let's create this screen shape with the glass effect. So how I did that? I take a front mockup from any devices and take only the screen. Let me detach instant first. Keep only the screen. You can delete everything. Keep only the screen. Ungroup this one. So we're gonna do the same step for the Skew that. Bring it here. Right click. Plugin. Skew that. It shouldn't be the same number as the preview UI. So it's minus 44. And for the vertical skew, 32. Apply. It should be like this. Now, I'm gonna change the color. First of all, I take off the screen. I'm gonna change only the screen shape. I'm gonna put white, 40% opacity. Add background blur on effect. Let's say 40. Now, add the body of this screen shape. So you can delete all of this. Okay, ungroup. Delete. Keep the screen shape. So you can do duplicate, command D, take the bottom layer, make a body like this. You can change the color, so I'm gonna red and then group together. When the screen glass is done, let's put together to make the design more nice. So I'm gonna bring the screen glass in the top of the card. Explore something like this. Let's play a little bit. There you go, your design is done. So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. And don't forget to subscribe, comment, and give me a big thumbs up. See you on the next video. Bye guys.